Hello, BCC Kids, and welcome again to Everyday Armor. Okay, BCC Kids, this morning we'll be talking about the good news boots, but before we do, let's play a game. I'm going to show you a pair of shoes, and I want you to guess who they belong to. Here we go.
You would think that sharing good news would be really easy, but there's a spiritual battle taking place between God and the devil over the hearts of each person on earth. God is fighting for people to know who he is and how much he loves them. But the devil, his enemy, is evil and will do anything to keep people from hearing the good news about God's love. So God gave us a piece of his armor called the Good News Boots. They give us the courage to go and tell the good news, just like Jesus taught his disciples to do. 3 days after Jesus died, God brought him back to life. Jesus appeared to his disciples on a mountainside near Galilee, and when they saw him, they worshiped him and thanked God for his love. Jesus had an important message he wanted them to understand. Jesus said, "Go and make followers of all the people in the world. Teach them to obey everything I have told you to do, and you can be sure that I will be with you always." The disciples knew that sharing the good news of God's love might be hard, but they did what Jesus asked them to do. When we decide to follow Jesus, we should tell the people around us the good news about him. It can be easy to make excuses like, "People might make fun of me," "I don't know what to say," or "It's too hard." But with the good news boots, God gives us the right words to say and helps us to not be afraid. Jesus' promise to the disciples is true for us too. He will always be with us. When we wear the good news boots, telling other people about God's love has the power to change their lives forever. We can put on the good news boots.
It's Joe on the go time.
Hey everyone, it's Joe on the go, and I'm Joe Miller, coming to you live each and every day as I take to the streets to give you all the deets. You know, we've been talking a lot about how everyday people in this awesome city of ours use the armor of God in amazing ways. Well, my friends, today is no exception. We are about to meet one of my faves. His name is Coach. I mean, that's what we call him. I'm like totally sure that's not what is on his birth certificate, but he goes by Coach. And I can't wait for you to meet him. Hey Coach, think fast.
Whoa, Joe, nice kick. I think I'm ready to put you on the field. Defense or offense?
Oh, I'm not so sure about that, but if you need a sub, I will do what I can. Okay, Coach, for reals, let's get right into it and talk stats. Now, you've led your team to 8 regional championships, 5 state cup victories, and 10 of your players have gone on to play pro. Oh, and it doesn't stop there. I've also read that as a coach, you have won 2 Golden Net Awards. FYI, that award goes to the coach who has voted like the best of the very best. Coach, you are basically an all-star. How do you do it? The love of the game, a special coaching technique?
Well, Joe, I do love the game of soccer, and coaching a great team is the best. But winning those games and awards isn't everything. It's more about developing the players.
Oh, don't you worry. I did my research. All I had to do was Google best soccer moves. So when you say developing the players, you mean things like perfecting their bicycle kicks, juggling, and headers? You know, kind of like that guy.
Now that is some fancy footwork. My players do work hard on the field each and every day. But really, at the end of the game, I want players who share the good news of God's love on and off the field.
That sounds like you were talking about a certain piece of God's armor right there.
Yes, of course, the good news boots.
Ding, ding, ding. Tell us more.
I knew that in order for my players to see what this looked like, I had to put on the good news boots first. That meant having the courage to share God's love with them. As their coach, they could follow my lead and have the courage to do the same.
Well, that is a great way to coach, Coach. Tell us, what does it look like for your team to put on the good news boots?
That's a great question. We decided to start doing things off the field to show God's love to other people.
Oh, wow, I like that game plan. Well, what kind of stuff did your team do?
We started helping the younger teams with their drills and skills, and while we were doing that, we were sharing the good news that God loves them. We also started praying with them before each game. That's a great way to put God at the center of what we do. The team also started volunteering together once a month, helping prepare a meal for those who might not have one. The really cool thing about all of this is that a lot of the players on our team initially had to build up the courage to share the good news, but by the end of the season, they had the confidence to share God's love with everyone. They all started as rookies and ended as pros.
Coach, that is so great. Hey, thanks for kicking it with us today and showing us how the good news boots can work in action. I am so glad your team had the courage to share with others about how much God loves them. That really helps all of us remember that we can share the good news with others too.
You sure can. It could be on your own sports team, in your school, neighborhood, or really anywhere. The good news boots will help you wherever you go.
Well, that's it for us today. Join us next time for Joe on the Go. I can't wait to see who we will meet next.
Okay, it's question time.
What piece of armor are we talking about today? If you guessed, Good News Boots, you're right. Was it always easy for the players to share the good news of God's love with others? No, not always easy. What are some things that coach and the team did to show God's love to others? Do you remember? They shared the good news and they prayed with the team.
Okay, well that almost closes our morning. As we always end with worship, we'll sing our praises to God and we will see you next week.
My hope exhausted, you will be my strength.